The Kairos Society is an organization of young entrepreneurs who say their mission is to find billion-dollar solutions to world challenges. Here to explain exactly what this means is founder and chairman of the Kairos Society, Ankur Jain, who is also the co-founder of Human, a tech company recently acquired by Tinder. Welcome, Ankur.
Hey,
so great to see you.
Yeah.
So the Kairos Society is 8 years old now. What was your thinking when you started it?
So 8 years ago, I was still an undergrad, and it was 2008, right when the Wall Street was crashing. And it was one of the more unique times, I feel like, for young people, because everyone's typical career path, especially coming out of these top universities, had been banking, consulting, and then you continued from there.
And all of that just evaporated.
And all of that evaporated. And what was happening is, at the same time, business was being considered this evil, bad, negative thing, mm-hmm. when in reality, like, our country's been built by entrepreneurs. And every successful industry has been built by entrepreneurs who have rethought how things were done. And so 8 years ago, we said, what if we could focus the next generation?
When you say we, you mean a couple of college buddies?
Yeah, a couple of my friends at Penn.
Okay.
And we said, what if we could focus our friends, this next generation, on actually solving these big industry problems, areas where governments and traditional industries have failed to innovate? And what's interesting is that over the 4 years from there, I mean, in the first couple of years, we had launched over 200 companies. The top 20 alone, which had raised over $650 million, tackling problems like the sleep industry. How do you think about retirement?
So tell us then, give us an example. You just said the sleep industry. So what did you do? How did you specifically tackle this problem?
So we have two parts to what we look at. Mm-hmm. One is, how do we actually identify the market failures and incubate new products? And so one of the challenges as a young entrepreneur is, it's very hard to know where to start. You say, I want to go solve healthcare, right? And meanwhile, you have all these healthcare executives saying, God, we need to figure out what the next big thing is. And there's actually a gap where these executives understand where the market failures are, but don't know what to do about it. And entrepreneurs can approach problems with a fresh, innovative perspective, but don't necessarily know where to focus. And so in an example like that, if you think about, like, if you look at healthcare, the majority of costs are actually chronic disease management.
Right.
And the market failure is not on the management side, it's actually the prevention side.
Right, right.
And so there's just been so little innovation on how do you think about preventing it. And so when you put young entrepreneurs on this, like we did at the Kairos Society, you end up with companies like PlateJoy, which are thinking about, how do we actually leverage personalized nutrition as a means to prevent these major chronic diseases early and build consumer products that actually get people to change their behavior.
So this is a company started by someone who's also a member of the Kairos
Society.
Correct. So you guys, how many members are there now?
So we have a venture fund that's invested in a group of companies around the world.
Mm-hmm.
The foundation piece has over 1,000 active fellows who are students from the top universities around the world at any given moment. And so the foundation really focuses on incubating these new ideas hand in hand with government and business leaders.
Okay.
And then the venture fund provides the capital needed for these entrepreneurs to really scale these companies.
So the society is sort of multi-layered.
That's correct. There's really two parts,
right?
The foundation and the venture fund.
Right. All right. So now you have a big global summit coming up right here in New York. Tell us about some of the things you have planned.
So, I mean, everyone has been following, I think, with pretty careful eyes how this the new global macroeconomic space is going to look with the new administration. And I think one thing is fairly clear is that regardless of what side of the aisle you fall on, we can't rely on government to solve these problems anymore. And so we've hosted this meeting in response to this as a way to say, okay, let's bring together the CEOs of the big Fortune companies, the heads of state of the largest countries in the world, and let's ask them, what would you want to focus the next generation of entrepreneurs on?
So that's what you're doing. Who are some of the bold-faced names you will be asking this to?
I mean, it's across the spectrum.
Yeah.
So we're really looking at, like, how do we bring folks like even President Vicente Fox from Mexico, mm-hmm. or the Prime Minister of Greece? Or how do we bring leaders like the CTO of Amazon or the CEO of Verizon to come in and answer these questions of really where are these market failures where we need young entrepreneurs to come innovate?
And so all of these companies will bring some sample of what they're working on to this. It'll happen at the New York Stock Exchange, is that right?
Yeah, so we're actually taking over the trading floor of the New York Stock Exchange and inviting a group of investors from around the world to come meet these founders.
I feel like the Stock Exchange is becoming a conference center now. There's all kinds of events there these days. It's great.
It's a fun space.
Yeah, that's great. Well, Ankur, thank you so much.
You've
got some very exciting things on your plate. Want to ask you, though, how's Tinder? How are you liking the new digs?
It's amazing. What's exciting about Tinder is Tinder started off by rethinking the dating market.
Mm-hmm.
And we're now at a stage where we have captured so much of that market that we're now starting to think, what's the next step? Like, where do we rethink how social interactions come together? And I'd say, I'll kind of end it with, every other social company in the world measures success by time spent on app. It's how do you keep eyeballs on your product to drive ad revenue? At Tinder, we're thinking, how do you measure success? By time spent together. And what do we need to do to facilitate that real world connection?
Nice. That's a great way to end it. Well, Ankur Jain, thank you so much for coming to see us. And have fun at the Global Summit.
Yes, thank you.